Welcome to Behold the Real Jesus broadcast, brought to you by the Jesus Christ International Church, 325 South High Street, Longview, Texas, zip code 75601. We want to take you into a live service in Moroni, Kenya, Africa, where we just preached Jesus Christ and how to be born again. In John 3, it says you must be born of the water and the Spirit, but what does that mean? And we have over 250 orphans that you're going to see in the film. In the clip that we're going to show you, along with about 50 widows, along with the town of Moroni. That's 30 kilometers west of Kisumu in Kenya. Well, with nothing further to say or do, let's go into that clip right now. The Lord Jesus bless you. John 16. I'm going to give you some principles. First thing, you must be born of the water and the Spirit. John 3, he said you must be born again. And so except a man be born again, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Marvel not that I said unto you that you must be born again. Nicodemus said to him, how is a man that is old enter the second time into his mother's womb? Jesus said, that which is flesh is flesh, that which is spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said to you, you must be born again. Matthew 28:19. Go ye into all the world, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever commanded you, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. And Lord, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world. Amen. The name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost is a singular name. Father is not a proper name. Son is not a proper name. The revealed name of the Father, the revealed name of the Son, the revealed name of the Holy Ghost is Jesus Christ. John 5, Jesus said, I'm coming in my Father's name. John 17 said, O Holy Father, I have manifested your name. Keep through thine own name those that thou hast given me, and have lost none, saying the Son of perdition, the scriptures might be fulfilled. When he was going into Jerusalem there to be crucified, they say, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord Jehovah God Almighty is Jesus. His very name means Jesus. Jehovah is salvation. Not Jehovah Jr. is salvation. Jehovah is salvation. The Emmanuel, God with us. Matthew 1:21, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. John 14, he said, I'll pray the Comforter for the Father for another Comforter, who the Father will send in my name. The Holy Ghost's name is Jesus. Therefore, go into all the world, teach you and observe all things whatsoever commanded you, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost,
Peter, having the keys of the kingdom, understood exactly what the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost is. For there's no contradiction in the Word of God. And knowing that Jesus said, you must be born of the water and of the Spirit. That on the day of Pentecost, when they were pricked in their heart, and they said, men and brethren, what must we do? Peter, standing up along with the other 11, said, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, which is the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Ghost. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins. Then you're born of the water, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Now you're born of the Spirit. There's no other way to be born again except water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, born of the water, and being filled with the Holy Ghost, born of the Spirit. So, we have been taught a lie. We've been taught a lie. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But that is not an intellectual belief. You have to believe with the heart, not with the head. Romans 10:9. That if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, not just confess with your mouth Jesus, confess with your mouth the Lord Jehovah God Almighty Jesus, and believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead. Not believe with thy mind, believe with thine heart. Then thou can be saved. For with confession, with the man, with the heart, man believeth. Not with the intellectual mind, man believeth. With the heart, man believeth. And confession is made unto salvation. Therefore, in Romans 2:28, he is not a Jew that is one outwardly in the circumcision of the flesh. He is a Jew that is circumcised of the heart. Circumcised in the inner man, in the heart, in the spirit. In the heart. How do you get the heart circumcised? That's the way you believe with your heart. He is not a Jew that is one not willing the circumcision of the flesh. But he is a Jew whose circumcision is in the heart, in the spirit. Whose praise is not of man, but of God. How do you have the heart circumcised, the spirit circumcised? The spirit to circumcise means to cut. Jesus is going to cut off the body of the sins. How do you do that? Nowhere in the Word of God did they say they bowed down and asked Jesus to come into their heart. Nowhere did they bow down and say the sinner's prayer. Peter said, they said, what must we do? Peter said, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Why? For the remission of your sins. That's born of the water. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. That is born of the Spirit. For the promises unto you and to your children, the many as are far off, even to as many as the Lord our God shall call. Take a look at Romans 6, 1 through 4. What, know you not? What, know you not? That to as many as you were baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, that were baptized into Christ's death. Romans 6, 4, that the body of the sins of the flesh might be destroyed. Colossians 2, verse 10 through 12. You see, your preachers have told you that baptism means nothing. Denomination, theologies, and seminaries say baptism means nothing. Mark 16, Jesus said, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He did not say he that believeth and is saved shall be baptized if you want to. He said, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Colossians 2:10, you're complete in him. And have need of nothing else. In whom you are circumcised with a circumcision made without hands. To putting off the body of the sins of the flesh. Colossians 2:12, by baptism. Through the circumcision of Christ. Through the operation of God. Through faith in the operation of God. The operation of God, God takes a spiritual scalpel. As you go down, born of the water, calling on the name of Jesus Christ, the circumcision of Christ made without hands, that circumcision of Christ, through the operation of God, through faith in that operation of God, God takes a spiritual scalpel, goes onto your heart, cuts off the body of the sins of the flesh and buries it. By baptism. By water baptism. There is no other way. Any other way, and anybody says any other way is a liar and a thief. I don't care what a seminary says. I don't care what a denomination says. The Bible says you must be born of the water and the Spirit. Water is water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, taken on the name of Jesus. For as many have been baptized into Christ and put on Christ. That is your wedding garment. You got it by baptism. Paul was on the Damascus Road. He saw a great light. He said, Saul, Saul, it's hard for you to kick against the pricks. It's hard for you to kick against the pricks. Paul had seen the Lord. He said, who are you, Lord? Who are you, Lord Jehovah? He said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. Then he tells him, you're called to go to the Gentiles. Then Paul was back. He was literally blinded for 3 days. Here is a man that has written 14 books of the New Testament. He's seeing the Lord. He's had the revelation of the name Jesus. He knows the will of God for his life that he's to preach. And he is healed of blindness. And he still is not saved. Ananias comes to Brother Saul, Paul. Ananias comes to Brother Saul. Turn Paul. And says, Brother Saul, receive thy sight. Why tarriest thou? Arise. Be baptized. Washing away your sin. Calling upon the name of the Lord. Paul was baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Paul was baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. But what are we going to do? That's only one way, born of water and the Spirit, is repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. You shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah! Born of the water and of the Spirit, there is no other way. Are you telling me I'm lost if I'm not baptized in the name of Jesus Christ? That's exactly what I'm telling you. That's exactly what I'm telling you. You're not born again. I don't care how good of a man you are. I don't care if you fast twice a week and give tithes of all that you possess. If you haven't been born of the water and the Spirit, you are not born again. And any time you want to tell me, Brother Beard, I don't believe this. We don't believe it. Get on down the road. I'll pack up on that bus and I'll leave. I'm here as a shoe shine boy to pop the rag and shine your shoes. Now, we've got 2 hours for me to give you a 6-hour message. That's not your fault, that's my fault. Tell me it's my fault. Me. Because everything that could go wrong today went wrong today because they was trying to keep us from getting here. We got stopped by the cops and we's going to get arrested. I'm not a criminal, neither is our bus driver. All right, here we go. You ready? Turn to 1 Peter 1. 1 Peter 1, verse 10 and 11. The Old Testament prophets prophesied. Searching what? Each one of those Old Testament prophets. That's Samuel, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, 14 minor prophets, all the way to Malachi. Search diligently into the salvation that should come unto us. Search in what manner of time? The Spirit of Christ that was in them. Christ is that Spirit.
Cristo en el lomo, no?
God is that spirit.
Lomo, no?
The Father is that spirit.
Lomo, no?
The Word is that spirit.
Lomo, no?
The Holy Ghost is that spirit. Elohim is that spirit. Jehovah is that spirit. God is that spirit. Christ is that spirit. Christ is that spirit. You have to know that or you will not make heaven your home. Christ is that spirit. Searching what manner of time the spirit of Christ that was in them. When it signified, when it testified beforehand of the sufferings of Christ, and the glory that should follow. But God is a spirit, cannot die, has no blood, and can't be tempted. Romans 5 said, by one man's disobedience, sin came to the world, and death by sin. Therefore, by one man shall my servant make many righteous. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. We have to have a kinsman redeemer. He's got to be one of us. He can't. It's not an angel. It's not the Spirit of God. A man lost it. Only a man can redeem us back. Only a man. God is a spirit. God is a spirit. God is a spirit. Philippians 2:6, Jesus being in the form of God. The Lord Jesus is that spirit. Jesus is the Lord. 2 Corinthians 3:17, the Lord is that spirit. They came to Jesus and said, you ain't yet 50 years old. Have you seen our father Abraham? He said, before Abraham was, I am.
Amen.
Before Abraham was, I am. Abraham rejoiced to see my day and he saw it. Abraham rejoiced to see my day and he saw it. Colossians 1:16 says all things were made by Jesus Christ. Whether it be thrones, principalities, powers, things visible, invisible. All things were made by him without anything was made with one made. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. Jesus is creator of all, Jesus is God. But Jesus, Philippians 2:6, who being in the form of God, Jesus is that spirit. But he had not taken on a permanent abode yet. It was Jesus in the burning bush. But he was not going to take on a permanent abode, a permanent tabernacle in a burning bush. Moses, take off your shoes from off your feet, for the ground you stand on is holy. I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. What happened to you? Did I wear you out? Come back here. Where you going? Hallelujah! I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. He said, I've seen their affliction, I've heard their cry. Go down to Egypt and deliver my people. He said, what is your name? When they ask me your name, I can tell them your name. He didn't say, I am Jesus. Why?
What do you mean?
Because he hadn't taken on a permanent abode yet. It hadn't taken on a permanent revelation yet. Oh, I thought they was talking about me. He hadn't taken on a permanent abode yet. He hadn't taken on a permanent revelation yet. He was not going to stay in a burning bush forever. Therefore, he said, I am that I am. Whenever they came to Abraham, three angels came to Abraham. Two went on down to Sodom and Gomorrah. One stayed back with Abraham. He called him Lord. That was Jesus, but he's not going to be staying in a form of an angel. Joshua saw him too. There was a man that was about to cross over the Jordan River in the battle of Ai before Jericho. He saw a man with a long sword drawn. Joshua looked at him and said, are you for us or are you against us? He said, neither. I'm captain of the Lord of hosts. Joshua, take off the shoes from off your feet, for the ground you stand on is holy. That was Jesus Christ. Jacob wrestled with the angel. Touched him in his thigh. And he asked him his name. He said, change his name from Jacob to Israel. That was the redeeming angel. Genesis 48 is called that the redeeming angel. Jesus has never been an angel. Jesus is not a burning bush. Jesus is not that man of the that had the sword drawn. Jesus is not a brazen serpent lifted up in the wilderness. That was a temporary abode. Would you take a rented house and chisel your name in the concrete? Chisel your name in the wood over that house, knowing that you're going to move to another house because it's just a temporary abode? Would you write your name in concrete in it? Neither would God write his permanent name in it until they took on an eternal abode, a permanent tabernacle forever. Jesus did not take on him the form of angels, the nature of angels. He took on him the seed of Abraham. When he was going to take on a fullness of that man, and what the law could not do, and that it was weak in the flesh. God sending his own son, the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh. Because by one man's disobedience, sin came to the world, and death by sin. Therefore, by a man shall my servant make many righteous. I showed you in Isaiah 43:10 yesterday. You are my witnesses. Thus saith the Lord. That's the Lord Jehovah God Almighty. And my servant whom I have chosen. That I am he. That you may know and believe that I am he. You don't get it. You're looking at me kind of funny. Isaiah 43:10. You are my witnesses. Every one of you, you are my witnesses. Thus saith the Lord. Thus saith the Lord Jehovah God Almighty. and my servant, whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe. It sounds like there's two of them. You are my witnesses, thus saith the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe that I, the Lord, am He, the servant. Only one. Only one. We've been duped, man of God. We've been lied to all of our lives. All of us. We've been lied to. Hallelujah. Every one of us have been lied to. I was lied to. You've been lied to. All of us have been lied to. Hallelujah. That you may know and believe that I am He. And beside me there is no God. There is no other God. That you may know that I am God, thy Savior. Amen.
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 Amen. Elder. Amen.
Amen.
I'm very interested in what you think and what you believe. Because you're the leader of this bunch. I'm very interested in what you believe. I don't care if I'm 100 years old. If I see something in that Word of God and I see it and God said, do it, I'm going to do it. I want to make heaven my home. I don't want to go to hell. So we got to do our job. So I'm going to make you sad, mad, or glad. You're going to be sad because you don't believe it. Or you believe it and you don't want to change. Mad because you don't believe it at all. Or glad because you do believe it and you're going to change. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now let's see how this Jesus is. Searching what manner of time the Spirit of Christ. This is the invisible Spirit. That Spirit you can't see. You're going to heaven, I'm there, you're going to hell, I'm there. Where's the house you'll be on me, David? Searching what manner of time the Spirit of Christ that was in the Old Testament prophets. When it signified, when it testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ. So Christ is going to make him a body of flesh and blood as you are my witnesses, that you may know and believe and understand that I, the Lord Jehovah, am that servant. That is me. The image of the invisible God, the expressed image of His person. John 8, 13. They came to Jesus and said, you bear record to yourself, Jesus, your record's not true. Said, no, I bear record to myself, my record is true. Because I'm not alone. The Father that sent me, He's with me. All they could see was this man of flesh and blood. They said, Jesus, you bear record to yourself, your record ain't true. He said, though I bear record to myself, my record is true. Because I'm not alone. The Father that sent me, He's with me. Jesus said, it's written in your law. The testimony of two men is true. I am one that beareth witness of myself. And my Father that sent me, He beareth witness of me. They said, where is your Father? Where is He? Where is your Father? They didn't understand they were looking at him. They didn't understand that Jesus is the image of the invisible God. That if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. They said, where is your Father? Jesus said, even the same that I said unto you from the beginning. If you'd have known me, you'd have known my Father. You're from beneath. I'm from above. You're of this world. I'm not of this world. More of Jesus spake these words in the treasury. No man laid hands on him because his hour was not yet come. More of Jesus said, I go my way. I go my way, and whither I go, you cannot come. Where is he going? Jesus said he was in the form of God. He's in the form of God. Philippians 2:6. Elder Philippians 2:6. Jesus, who being in the form of God, that spirit made himself of no reputation, took upon him the form of a servant. Who is that servant? You are my witnesses that you may know and believe that I am he, and beside me there is no other God. That you may know and believe that I am God thy Savior. Jesus, being in the form of God, made himself of no reputation, took upon him another form. He was in the form of God, took upon him the form of a servant. Made himself of no reputation. He was in the form of God. Took upon him the form of a servant. Made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man. Who was found in fashion as a man? God was found in fashion as a man. God was found in fashion as a man, humbling himself to the death of the cross. Wherefore God hath highly exalted him. That's the reason Jesus said, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Because I am the Father, I'll raise up my own body. No man can raise up his own body except it be God. Jesus is that God. He is that Lord. Jesus said, I go my way. Where are you going? He said, I came from the Father, and I came into the world. Now I go back to that glory of the Father. I proceeded from the Father, and I came into the world. Now I go back to the Father. I proceeded from him. I go back to him. I came from God. I go back to God. I came out from God. I came back to God. I came out from God. I come back to God. 1 Timothy 3:16. If I proceed with the love of God, because he laid down his life for us. God laid down his life for us. Acts 20:28. Take heed to yourself over all the flock, over which the Holy Ghost has made us overseers, to feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. His own blood! God's own blood! Hallelujah! Come on, give him glory! Hang on. Hang on. It's just going to get good. We're not going to be saved just through the person of Jesus. Not only going to be saved through the person of Jesus, we got to know the work of Jesus. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory! Yeah.
Hallelujah!
Hey! Glory! Yes! Amen! Yes, Papa! 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 Amen!
Sit down.
Yes.
Sit down.
Yes.
Sit down.
Please.
Amen.
Preach.
Yes.
You better watch it. You liable to be the true children of God here.
Amen.
Jesus.
Yes.
Jehovah's salvation.
Yes.
Made himself with no reputation. Emptied out his glory. Took upon him the form of a servant. That servant is the Lord Jesus Christ. The Father manifest in flesh. 1 Timothy 3:16 gives you the mystery of godliness. Without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh. Justified in the spirit. Believed on the world, seen of angels, preaching to the Gentiles, received up into glory. God was, not the Son of God. God was. The Son of God has two components. The Son of God is the Father, revealed in a body of flesh and blood. The Father is the invisible spirit. The Son of God is the Father revealed in a body of flesh and blood. The Father is the invisible spirit. That's the reason John 14, Jesus said, you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, if any mansion would not so, I'd go to prepare a place for you. I would have told you so. While Jesus, now watch this. He is the Spirit of God. Listen to me. But the Spirit can't die. The Spirit has no blood. The Spirit can't be tempted. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. A man lost it, only a man can redeem us back. The devil thinks he's got it won. God looked for a man. He was amazed he could find none. He was amazed he could find none. Because all was conceived in sin, shape and iniquity, none good, no, not one. Therefore, God said, my own arm brought salvation to myself. God was in Christ, reconciling the world back into himself. Jesus Christ is that spirit. But man is lost and undone. Therefore, sin separated God from all mankind. So God gave a law. The law was given. Give me that. The law was given. No, go ahead. Give me that. The law was given. That sin might appear exceedingly sinful. You see this law? The law separates. Sin separated God from all his creation. Where it's communicated from the fellow citizens of the Commonwealth of Israel. Without hope, without God in this world. But we're made nigh by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Therefore, the law was given that sin might appear exceedingly sinful. And separated God from all mankind. God's got to do something about that. That law requires death. That law requires the shedding of blood. Because Adam, in the day that you sinned, you brought forth death upon all mankind. The only way you're going to redeem it back is by shedding of blood. For without the shedding of blood, no flesh will be saved. But a man's going to have to keep that law, and he's going to have to be one of us. He's going to have to be our kinsman redeemer. Therefore, God, who is holy, who is righteous, who is spirit, cannot redeem us. So he makes himself of no reputation, lays aside his glory to come under his own law. And takes on a form of flesh. But he can't work as the Spirit of God. He must work as a man. And as a man breaks down this law by sufferings, the Spirit of God can break through and show himself through the man. The law states in Numbers 4 that the high priest, and under this law, cannot be a high priest until age 30. Therefore, Jesus will work no miracles. He will work no wonders until age 30. Why? Because he would break his own law. Jesus, as a man, must fulfill his own law as a man. The law states a high priest doesn't take his office until age 30. Therefore, Jesus won't work a miracle and won't start his ministry until age 30. And then when he does, there's going to be a transfer of the Levitical priesthood to that of Melchizedek. Stand up. This is my son. This is my son. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Don't go to sleep on me. Stand up. I didn't say you could sit down. Stand up. You're my son. You're under the law. It's time for me to retire. I'm a high priest and under the law. Now, my son is now 30 years old. I'm going to do three things. Number one, I'm going to lay hands on. Number one, I'm going to pour oil on him. Number two, I'm going to put my hands on him. And number three, I'm going to speak over him. Thou art a high priest in my stead. I'm going to retire from the priesthood. And my son will be the high priest from that day forward. Jesus is about 30 years old. He's a man just like you and just like me. Hebrews 2 said, for as much then as the children are protectors of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same. Then in all things he was made like unto his brethren, tempted at all points like as we are, yet without sin. Jesus, being about the age of 30, so he can keep his own law, therefore comes to John. John the Baptist. And said, baptize me. He said, I have need to be baptized of you. Of whose shoes latches, I'm not worthy to stoop down and unloose. Jesus said, suffer to be so to fulfill all righteousness. Are you losing me now? Are you with me? Are you with me? That law states that that high priest can't take his office until age 30. Jesus can't take his office until age 30. He's fulfilling that law as a man. Even though he's God, he's made himself of no reputation to work as a man. He's under his own law to fulfill that law as a man. All right, he's down there, John the Baptist. John the Baptist lays hands on him. Two, puts him under the water. Three, raises him up. All he has to do is speak over him, but he doesn't speak. There's a voice comes from heaven. Thou art my son, in whom I'm well pleased. Then the Holy Ghost, in the shape of a dove, comes down and rests upon Jesus. The heavens are open to Jesus. And he begins his ministry as our great high priest. He has not broken that law. He's fulfilling that law in every jot and every tittle. Before that Holy Ghost came down, God had made himself of no reputation, no glory. But when that dove came down, the Holy Ghost in the shape of a dove came down, it rested upon the shoulder of Jesus. And from that day forth, God, who had made himself of no reputation, began to work through the man. Because he fulfilled his own law, he can start working as our high priest for us. He was not filled. Jesus was not filled with the Holy Ghost. He is the Holy Ghost. How Christ Jesus was anointed of the Holy Ghost. It was already there, but he had made himself of no reputation. The Holy Ghost was there. God gave it not the Spirit by measure to him. When that child was born in Bethlehem, they came and worshipped him. Because he gave not the Spirit by measure unto him. He had all the Spirit of God. But the Spirit was not work. He's made himself of no reputation. Because he must fulfill the law as a man. But at age 30, he's been baptized of John in Jordan. He starts working as our great high priest. As he's baptized, that dove, the Holy Ghost comes down on as a form of a dove and starts showing himself, revealing himself through the man Christ Jesus. How God anointed Christ Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost went about doing good, healing all manner of sickness and disease. Jesus is on that side. Go sit down in that chair over there. From this time over here, he's working on our behalf. But God now is revealing himself through him as our great high priest. He hasn't broken his law because the high priest takes his office at age 30. As long as this law is here, God is separated from his creation. It's separated. It's a wall of partition. Parts. It parts God from man. It's parting God from man. And what the law could not do, in that it was weak in the flesh, God sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. But you have been taught that God the Spirit said to God Junior, go down there and die for the sin of the world. Nowhere did the Spirit say to another Spirit Junior, go down and die for the sin of the world. That's a lie out of hell. God did send forth his son. Well, how did he do it? Galatians 4, verse 4. In the fullness of time, God sent forth his son. How? Made of a woman. Made under the law. That's how God sent forth his son. As a man, Jesus is working as a man in our stead to redeem us to show us the way, the truth, and the life back to God. Therefore, here's a question for you. When Jesus is born, he has a spirit of God without measure. He is God manifest in the flesh. He's Emmanuel, God with us. But is that law still there? Jesus is born. God is manifest in flesh. Is the law still there? Is that law still separating God from all his creation and from all mankind? Is it still there? Is God spirit? Is the Son of God this spirit revealed in flesh? But the law is still there, isn't it? Is it still there? Is he in our stead showing us the way? The law is still there, isn't it? If the law is still there, is it still God separated from all mankind? Question, is Jesus a man like us? Is he in our stead? Then there is a wall of partition, even though he is the Son of God, the Father manifest in a body of flesh and blood. As long as that law is still there, there is a wall of partition that parts God from man, even though God and all the fullness of the God is in that man, is still a wall of partition in his flesh. Until that flesh is destroyed, that wall is still there. Can he just say, well, you're saved, or does he have to die? Well, wait a minute. He's got to fulfill the whole law as a man. Be found perfect, spotless, and blameless, keeping all this law. And he'd be free, willing freely to lay down his life.